The children of Gaza are suffering. Many are struggling to survive. Homeless and in need of food and water. Today, this is not about the rights and wrongs of the conflict. These people simply need your help. Several hundred have been killed in Gaza in recent weeks. A large number of them have been children. Some of those who have survived are traumatized from the loss of loved ones. UK aid agencies report that 60% of the population is now living in poverty. Thousands are malnourished, with more than 1 million dependent on aid to survive. And the UN says the number of homeless is in the thousands, with 300,000 people without access to running water. As residents here return to the rubble which used to be their homes, the scale of the devastation is only now becoming evident. Entire streets have been flattened, and in some areas, Gaza looks like it's been hit by an earthquake. Aid workers on the ground say that temporary shelters are finding it difficult to cope with the number of people now living on the streets. The UN reports that 40% of the population are without electricity, causing a virtual collapse of the sewage system and creating an additional public health risk. The hospitals have been overwhelmed with the number of casualties and need more resources to treat them. This is why the DEC has launched this appeal on behalf of its members. They just want to help save lives. They are already working on the ground, but need more money as supplies are running short. So please, donate now. You can give online by going to our website at www.dec.org.uk or donate by telephone at our 24-hour automated credit or debit card line. Please call now on 03 70 60 60 900. That's 03 70 60 60 900. Or you can donate over the counter at any post office. Just £25 can provide blankets for 8 children, £50 can pay for food for a family for 1 month, and £100 will provide a tarpaulin and a kit for a temporary shelter. Please, act now. This region may be used to violence, but many of these children are not. Whatever you are able to give, every pound will make a difference to their survival and help avoid a worsening humanitarian disaster. Thank you.
The BBC won't broadcast the appeal. I'm going to do it myself. Anyone who wants to contribute,
I'm sorry, you're not going to stop me.
The Disaster Emergency Committee Gaza Crisis is available at P.O. Box 999, London, EC3A3AA. And I know from the BBC, because I've been here most of the morning, nobody here agrees with what the BBC have done. 1,330 people have been killed, 460 children, 5,480 casualties. And the reason the BBC have done it is very simple. The Israeli government objected.
Well, the BBC would disagree with you, and you did hear the line from management there that it's a question of raising impartiality. The public will be concerned. And the other issue, of course, will the aid actually get to the people?
Well, if you're telling me that if I send money to Gaza, the BBC's impartiality of effect. I'm sorry, I'm a human being.
If you sent money to Gaza, though, through an appeal, can you be sure that it will get to the people who
well,
who
in
want
a war
it,
situation, the Israelis have killed 1,330 people. Now, Livni, the Israeli foreign minister, said there is no humanitarian crisis. Now, be clear, the Israelis objected to the BBC. That's the reason. I've never met anyone and I've done masses of meetings. I've never met anyone who doesn't think we should give aid to Gaza.
What about the other broadcasters who are also not showing it, though?
Well, they're wrong as well. But you see, we are human beings. I know you work for the BBC and I'm a pensioner. We're people. If you saw children dying as they are today in Gaza because there's no food, medical, wouldn't you want to send it?
We have shown what's been happening in Gaza.
I know you've shown it, but I'm talking about trying to help people.
Yes, but surely people will see it and send the money anyway. What difference does it
make? They don't know the address, and that's it. P.O. Box 999, London EC3A, 3AA. I'm doing what the BBC won't do.
And you did it earlier as well, and I think people now know what the address is. Can we look at the bigger picture, though, as well?
Yes, of course.
What about targeting the aid going to the people who need it? What about the problem, possibility, that it might go to Hamas, that it might actually go to rearm?
Well, all right. Hamas is the elected government in 2006. Hamas won the general election in Palestine. Jimmy Carter, the former American president, said that. And if you're telling me that no aid can go to people dying there in case it goes to a school run by Hamas, I mean, it just doesn't make sense.
How much money do you think the appeal will lose by not having the BBC and the other broadcasters broadcast?
Well, the Congo, they got 10 million, and I think in Burma, 18 million. People will die because of the BBC decision. Let me be clear about that. And I started my life 60 years ago as a BBC producer. I love the BBC. I support it. But it has capitulated to Israeli pressure. That's the truth, I have to tell you.
بعد بحث طويل عثرنا على دلال أبو عيشة في منزل جدها وأخوالها وهي لا تفارق جدتها منذ استشهاد والديها وإخوتها الثلاثة.
وقالت له مين؟ قالها كل عائلته. احنا جنينا سلمى بلطو.
نجت لعدم وجودها في المنزل لحظة القصف.
انا صرت يتيمة.
مين مات حبيبتي؟ مين
استشهد؟ قالوا لنا بابا وماما واخوتي.
كلهم؟ مين هم؟
السيد ومحمد وغيداء.
ما يخفف جزءا من معاناتها صور لإخوتها وجدتها في بيت خالها.
هذا محمد وهذا غيداء وهذا سيد.
فدلال كما تقول الجدة تبقى الذكرى الوحيدة لأمها.
خمس تنفار يا أختي، أولاد تنين وبنت وجوزها وهي. خمس تنفار يا أختي.
يا دلال،
هي دلال يا اختي اللي بقت من ريحة امها دلال عنا يا امه.
بصحبتنا تستعد دلال للذهاب لمنزلها المدمر بعد اكثر من اسبوعين. خطواتها مترددة وصدمتها كبيرة. هنا كان منزل فقد معالمه، لكن ذكرياته لا تفارق دلال.
هذه غرفتي. هي ما غرفة ماما. هنا الصالة تبعتنا. هنا كانينا بأخوتي.
في كل الاتجاهات تحركت، ولكل من أفراد أسرتها حاولت انتشال ذكرى.
تمريو الغيداء. وهذا قميص محمد.
وسط الحزن سرقت بسمتها الوحيدة عندما التقطت قطتها من وسط الركام.
خلاص.
كلهم ذهبوا وبقيت لها القطة. أغراض تناثرت وذكريات تجمعت، وبقي لدلال الحزن والدموع ومستقبل مجهول.
ذنبي أنا، أحرموا لأهلي، ليش سويت لهم أنا؟ يهود، حسبي الله عليهم.
في هذا المنزل قصفت أسرة بأكملها واستشهد أفرادها إلا دلال. دلال بقيت وحيدة كآلاف الأطفال في قطاع غزة، فقدوا الأب أو الأم أو الإخوة. إنهم ضحية الحرب الإسرائيلية على قطاع غزة، والتي استهدفت بالدرجة الأولى المدنيين. هبة عكيلة، الجزيرة، غزة، فلسطين.